Hi, hello, welcome to Homeschool. This is your class 10 mathematics. Today in this session, I am going to explain you about 30 days schedule plan. How we are going to plan for our examination. That is from May 13th to June 13th. As your KCEB board have decided your examinations will be starting from June 21st, 2021. We don't have much time to prepare. This is very difficult situation. In this pandemic situations, we are trying to give a quality education and also a perfect schedule plan for you. I hope everybody are doing good at your home. Keep a good practice. Practice makes you perfect in mathematics. Practicing mathematics is very easy. Once if we understand, we never forget. There is nothing to buy heart in mathematics. If we understand, mathematics is very friendly for us. This 1 month, we do a perfect plan for mathematics such that we should score 80 out of 80 in mathematics. Each chapter weightage in mathematics I'm going to say for you, and total 80 marks, and how many days we can divide each chapter and how we are going to practice, we are going to discuss in this session. If you practice in this manner for this 1 month, you are definitely are going to rock in your examinations. Let's start a schedule plan with blueprint first. See here, in this, out of 15 chapters, 4 chapters were deleted and you will be having 11 chapters. That is, your chapter number 5, areas related to circles, is deleted. And your chapter number 8, real numbers, is deleted. 9, polynomials, is deleted. And 14, probability, is deleted. So other than these 4 chapters, I am going to discuss the blueprint now. First chapter, arithmetic progression. 9 marks. Triangles, 8 marks. Pair of linear equations, 11 marks. Circles, 6 marks. Constructions, 5 marks. Coordinate geometry, 7 marks. Quadratic equation, 7 marks. Introduction to trigonometry, 7 marks. Some applications of trigonometry, 4 marks. Statistics, 7. And surface areas and volumes, 9 marks weightage. Total 80 marks. According to this year annual examination, this might be a blueprint. So 1 or 2 marks may be interchanging from one chapter to another chapter. This side you can see the schedule plan how I have given. See there, May 13th to June 13th. 1 month we have given. By this time, most of the children might be completed your mathematics full syllabus. That means your textbook exercises and also examples and some of the application questions you might have practiced. But now we are left with only 1 month. This 1 month we are going to utilize without wasting a single day. Okay, let's start a revision plan. From May 13th to June 13th, I have given your revision plan according to the importance of the chapter. See here, May 13th. First day we take only for theorems. Theorems, why we are taking first day theorems? Theorems carries 8 to 9 marks. Compulsory we are going to get. And you have seen in the channel theorems in one shot. All the theorems which are important for your annual examination is there in a single video. Watch the video of theorems where I have done in a single video all theorems in one shot. Watch the video once and write all the theorems without seeing. And next, coming to next day, pair of linear equations. Pair of linear equations have a weightage of 11 marks. See here, comparing to all chapters, this chapter weightage is more. So 11 marks weightage, it is very important for us, right? After theorems, we need to start with pair of linear equations in 2 variables. 3 days, this brackets you can see here, I have written days. 3 days, how we are going to plan? First day, we are going to solve the equations by elimination method. First day we go with solving the equations by elimination method, and the second day we go with verbal problems, and the third day we go with only graphs. Graphs is very important question in this examination. How you know theorems are compulsory? One graph is compulsory and one verbal problem and one pair of linear equations in two variables solving is also important. In this, other two methods were deleted. Substitution method and cross multiplication method was deleted. Only we are left with elimination method. 3 days completed. First day, solve the equations. Second day, verbal problems. You just go through. No need of practicing all problems. Pages together. No need. Just write the equations, solve the equations in very short. While we are doing revision, just try to go with the shortcuts. Okay? And here, graphs. On this day, practice only graphs. Coming to next day, statistics. Statistics is very easy and we can score easily 7 marks. That also video is provided in this channel. Complete statistics in one shot. That means out of 5 variety of problems, definite 2 problems will be there. That means you may score 6 to 7 marks from this chapter. So I have given you 2 days. How we are going to divide these 2 days? First day you go with mean, mode, that's it. And the second day you go with median and all ogives, less than type, more than type ogive and cumulative frequency graphs. Okay, then coming to constructions, next compulsory question we can guess is from constructions. Its weightage is 5 marks. Constructions, we can guess 2 or 3 compulsory questions in that. That may be similar triangle or external tangent or a tangent. Any two questions are compulsory. So 2 days I have allotted here. First day, just go with similar triangles and dividing a line segment. Next day, you just go with only tangents. So these 2 days you practice some important questions of drawing a similar triangle and tangents. Coming to next chapter, arithmetic progressions. We are going to take 3 days. In arithmetic progression, one very important question will be given for 4 marks. As you can see in your channel playlist, I have provided for you 1 mark questions, 2 mark questions and also 4 mark questions are also there. So 3 days you allot like this. First day you go with 1 and 2 marks questions. And your second day 4 marks. Third day also 4 mark questions only. So 2 days you use for 4 marks questions. So take your textbook example problems, which is important in this chapter you feel. Practice each and every problem carefully from this chapter. Okay, so 3 days. First day, go for 1 and 2 marks type of questions what there in your channel playlist. All the varieties of 1 and 2 marks I have done in this video. So you can go through in the first day and second day, third day, 2 days you utilize for 4 marks questions. Next, very important chapter and most confusing chapter is surface areas. So don't worry, I'll make you very easy. And all the chapters, each and every problem there in our channel. You can go through the description box and every problem is there in that. Surface areas and volumes, first part, if you observe, you can understand complete chapter with formulas. Okay, each and every problem with the figure showed for you very clearly. This chapter, most of the children feel difficulty, but don't worry, in this channel, you can see this chapter from first part. If you observe, you can understand every formula, how to identify the formula and how to frame the formula and each and every problem visually I have explained very clearly. So you can go through this chapter from the channel. So all the chapters are provided in the description box. Any problem you have a doubt, you can go through the videos. So surface areas, 5 days, what we are going to do? First day, we are going to learn only formulas. We are going to understand all the solids formulas on the first day. Second day, we are going to do separate solids. Suppose if any cone given, separate, second day you go for the problems, such a way that cone LSA given, height given, radius missing, like this. So go for second day, try to solve small problems. And for the third day, combination of solids, you have Excels in your textbooks. Go for third day with the combination of solids. And next day, conversion of solids. Combination means hemisphere, cylinder and a cone is placed. That is a combination type of problems. Conversion, cylinder is melted to form into cone, or a sphere is melted into small spheres. That is nothing but the conversion of solids. So you can go for third day and fourth day. Coming to fifth day, you can have a revision of all example problems from this chapter. So 5 days will be completed. Next, coming to coordinate geometry. Coordinate geometry is also very important. We can score 7 marks from this chapter. So 2 days, how we are going to divide this coordinate geometry? First day, you go with all the exercises of distance. Make sure these concepts should be covered completely. Okay, distance formula and section formula. Coordinate geometry, first day you try to cover distance and section formulas. Distance from origin or a distance between two coordinates. And these are all you can cover, section formula and all. Second day you go with the area of a triangle, 3 coordinates given or 4 coordinates given, parallelogram, area. These are all those type of problems give little preference and practice on second day. With that, coordinate geometry 2 days revision is also completed. Next chapter, quadratic equations. Quadratic equations is also having a weightage of 7 marks. So I'm going to divide this chapter for 3 days. How we are going to divide? On the first day, what we are going to do? We are going to factorize the equation. In this chapter, completing square method and cross multiplication method is deleted. So we have here only factorization method and formula method. So first day you go with factorization of equations, factorization and by using formula. Okay, second day you just go with all verbal type of problems. First verbal problem, convert into equations, then try to factorize. And coming to third day, do all example problems of this chapter are very important for your annual examination. In quadratic equation, 1 verbal problem will be compulsory and 1 equation factorizing is also compulsory. Factorization and formula method, verbal problems, examples. Along with examples, you try to do here nature of roots. Nature of roots is also very important for 2 marks. And next, introduction to trigonometry, take 3 days. In this 3 days, first day, only trigonometric ratios, complementary angles, and the table, trigonometric ratio table is very important. First day, you try to learn only those identities. Coming to second day, try to solve ratio application problems. It might be complementary angles problems, it might be. Try to solve on second day, complementary angles or ratio problems. And coming to third day, last exercise, which is very, very important for 1 4-marks question will be from this last exercise. So 1 complete day give preference for this exercise. Some applications of trigonometry. Some applications of trigonometry, you'll be getting only 1 question, that too 4 marks. So we'll take only 1 day. Try to frame the picture carefully by reading the question and apply the ratio. So I'll give you 1 day full some applications of trigonometry. Circles, already in this important topic is theorems. Theorems already we have done on the first day. So what we are going to do here? Missing angles, it might be what is the central angle or the problems which are left other than theorems. Okay, the circles, let us take 2 days. Coming to your last triangles. In triangles, almost important theorems are already done on the first day. I have allotted for triangles 3 days. These 3 days, you just go for application of Pythagoras problems, it may be, and BPT application problems. Let's complete exercise problems. So I have given these two chapters last. So according to the highest marks, weightage and preference, I have given this schedule plan. So total, this is for 30 days schedule plan. So practice well carefully. Total 30 days planning is this one. Please practice properly all the important concepts. Concept wise, you make clear of the topic and get a good result this year. I hope you are going to rock the result. All the best for your exams. And this year you are all very lucky, such that your question paper is not so difficult and it is not so twisted with application problems. Only 5% may be twisted. So getting direct questions, you have more chance. Most of the people will be doing mistakes in examination only at the multiplications or calculations, or while you have a negative sign, you should be very careful. Instead of negative, if you miss that negative sign, definitely your problem goes wrong. And in statistics, calculation starting, if you do any mistake, full problem goes wrong. So while you are doing the calculation part and also writing equations, signs, and 3 threes are, you have a habit of writing 6. 3 threes are is 9, but in examination you go on writing with 6. 2 plus 3, you may write it as 6. So these are very tiny mistakes. Those mistakes are very tiny, but if we lose marks, that is more for us in our examination, right? We should not lose any mark. So be careful in writing mathematics. After writing your examination, at least 10 minutes, you just keep only for rechecking your paper. All the best for your exams. Thank you all.